Hi guys, welcome to Tactical Combat System channel. For today I will show you some tips and training methods that you can apply in your daily training at home. Because of this situation with the lockdown and with the virus, all the gyms and the shooting range are closed. So I will show you some tips how you can continue your training at home. For today's video, I will use the next tools. A pocket knife, a folder knife, not automatic, it's manually. A tactical pen. And another fixed blade, little, that I am having on the belt. Much later, I will use also a fire weapon, showing you some exercises. Of course, in this situation, it's a replica, an airsoft replica that I will use in this environment. Even if this kind of situation is difficult and you don't have access anymore to your environment in which until now you were training, you must not quit the training. You must have the discipline to continue your training, doesn't matter where. For this kind of training, you need only a room in your apartment, in your house, and you can make many training techniques that can help you to remain on the same level or also to grow. What I see in general is that people are investing a lot of money in the best equipment on the market. They are buying the most expensive optics for their guns, the most expensive tactical clothes, the most expensive knives, and so on. So too much energy invested in materials and less energy invested in their real training that you can make with simple things. For example, for today training, I don't need an advanced target or a mannequin or these training mannequins that you can apply your techniques with a knife on it. And for the precision and training of my precision, I will use a simple paper that it's wrapped with adhesive band until it's becoming more hard. And after, I am sticking it with adhesive band on the wall. Of course, you can find different kind of methods and different kind of places to put these kind of things. I only show you that with a simple thing, you can improvise a little small target that it will help you with your precision when you are striking with the knife. Please, if you are a beginner or you don't master your techniques very good, use a trainer knife, a rubber knife, or a trainer for your folder. Don't use a real knife. I will start first to show you one exercise with the fixed blade that I have on my belt. Basically, this kind of wearing the knife, it's one of my favorites because many times it's better concealed. If you are looking, if you wear a folder and you have it in your pocket, it's very easy for somebody that is trained to or watch for these things to observe that you have a folder, a knife with you. So here under the t-shirt on the belt, it's a very good concealed low profile place to put your knife. And it's also very easy for me because many times when I have my handgun, I am carrying in the appendix position, in the holster, in the appendix position. So the movement of deploying the gun is the same with the movement of deploying the weapon. So the mechanism of catching the t-shirt, they take it up, take my gun and shoot, is the same with taking the t-shirt up as much as I can, catch the knife and use it. This fixed blade, put it in this position, will be all the time much faster than deploying a folder that is in a pocket or in other parts of your clothes. Why? Because to deploy the folder means that I must catch it, take it out, open it, and then use it. When we talk about the same strong hand that is using the knife. In this situation, I only catch the t-shirt with the other hand the strong hand is going on the knife and I'm already out with it and I can use it. Don't forget, having a knife with you and using the knife, it's a very complicated topic. Using the knife in my mentality and philosophy of tactical combat system, it's only applying in the moment in which you and your family, your life and your family life is putting in deadly danger, in a deadly force situation, so you don't have other mechanisms to protect your life and your loved one. So I will show again how you can extract the knife from this position. Strong hand, weak hand, or in the situation in which you train, they can become the both strong. The weak hand is going on the t-shirt, catching as much as it can of the clothes, and it's taking the t-shirt up as much as you can. The other hand is going on the knife, deploying it and ready to use to hit. So it's now applying this exercise on our target, it will be, you can start for example in the beginning without moving from the place. I repeat, doesn't matter what you do, knife, you are in the situation in which you must use the knife, you are in a situation in which you must use the gun, doesn't matter, or empty hands. Fixed position, it's dead position. Never stay in a fixed position all the time, move, because fixed targets are dead targets. So in this situation, for the beginning, only to exercise this movement, you will do it on the same place. Yeah, I was showing you earlier. So because this is my target, imagine that this is the face of the target, because I cannot go immediately. If I have the target in front of me and I am going immediately to extract my knife from the position, I cannot be much faster, or maybe if he's not aware of the situation, I cannot be much faster, and I will expose myself, my face and other parts of the body to this target that can hit me or counterattack. So first, what I'm doing with my hands up, if I'm in this kind of situation, I only make a simple scenario, I'm hitting only to distract the attention on the face. Yeah, and then the hand after hitting is going directly on the t-shirt, dragging the t-shirt, taking the knife, stabbing. So, bam, 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 bam. So by hitting this first strike, I create the time necessary to deploy my weapon. I repeat, I show you this technique by standing in the same place, but normally I am hitting, I am taking my knife, stabbing and going up back. I'm not remaining in that zone. So again, I'm in the position, strike, I'm going on the t-shirt, hit. Normally, you can, after you make few times and you master a little bit this kind of movement, you can make one striking, two is going on the t-shirt. I have a deadly space here, yeah, in which I'm uncovered. So after I'm striking, this hand can protect my chin or my part of my neck, if in case of, I don't know, a knife attack or something. It's very complicated to create now scenarios. I only show you some techniques and tips that you can put in your training. So one is going, then I'm closing my part of my of the neck. I am taking up the t-shirt. After my strong hand is already catching the knife, this hand is going again on the level of the face. This is meaning that the level of the middle body, Yeah, it's remaining free, heart or other parts of the thoracic box, where I can take the knife and stab it under the thoracic box, entering, if with this knife, I don't know if I can touch the heart, if I can penetrate the heart, because it's a small blade. But because of that part is remaining free, it's more easy to strike there. So I have one, I'm catching 2, 3 in the face, or one, I'm catching 2, 3. So I will show you now the same technique, but when I have in the beginning combat hand-to-hand attack, in which the aggressor is attacking with the punches. So I am protecting, I'm entering protection guard. One hand is covering on the back in case that they are more aggressive and one strike is coming from behind. The elbow is facing in front, but also protecting all of this part from his hooks or uppercuts. The other hand is coming on it, doing the same thing, and I'm in a strong position that is protecting me and also permitting me to this distance to see the aggressor. This kind of guard, it's only for fraction of second, 1-2 punches, in which you protect yourself, and then you must create the time and the distance to deploy your weapon. So from a normal position, I am entering in the protection position in the guard. From here, I begin to strike. And let's say that in this moment, after I'm having, it's only a scenario, it's a thing that is helping you combine hands to pass from hand combat contact to deploying the weapon. It's nothing fixed on the street, nothing is fixed. It's not that you will make this if tomorrow is happening something. This kind of exercise is all only help you to make a fast connection from hand-to-hand combat passing to deploying your weapon, yeah? So I'm entering in a guard position. From here I'm striking, boom, yeah? One, one, two. And after I'm doing the striking, one, two, this is the time in which I create a little bit of time. Normally I'm going one, two, I'm going back, protecting, taking the t-shirt up, taking my knife and be ready to strike. Okay. I'm not fighting with somebody, I'm beginning a fight. And I fight empty hands. And suddenly I take my knife out and I stab him, because I will go to jail. So this only, it's a scenario that you can coordinate the movements. Let's say that I'm fighting and after I'm making this, I'm seeing that he's taking from his pocket the knife and take it out. So then I'm taking out also and I'm in a guard position. So covering, one, two, taking the knife, stabbing if I need to stab. At the target, covering, one, two, taking the knife, stab, go back. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. So, okay. I want to show you now that this kind of deployment can be done with only one hand, because in every situation, it's different. And let's say you have the child with you, yeah? You have somebody that is coming with a knife or I don't know what. You have the child near you or something, or you must protect in the first time of the attack. You must protect it, and this hand cannot be used for the t-shirt. So let's, or maybe I am striked, maybe I am cut, doesn't matter, it can be all the situation. This kind of technique, it can be done with also one hand. I am taking the t-shirt up, taking the knife out. Normally it cannot be so fast like when I am doing it with two, but it's also helping depending on the situation, yeah? I am here taking out, taking the knife. Taking out, taking the knife. You see, every time when I am taking out, I am taking the t-shirt, I am taking the knife, and also move, so I will be with the knife in front already to strike, so I can maintain a distance. If I remaining only in this position, this hand, it's empty. I cannot cut, I cannot do nothing with it, yeah? So I need my knife. So this is the reason why, if it's very fast, you can already strike. So I'm here, I'm taking out, strike. Good, we pass now to the folder, yeah? To the pocket knife. This, I was showing you also in other videos. It's a manually folder knife, normally to open, if I don't put the movement, the energy to make this kind of movement. Normally, if you only push this, is happening this. So you must use the both hand. But pushing the button in the same time, making this kind of movement, it's physics and it's opening, yeah? Okay, it require a little bit of training and after, and knowing your folder knife, yeah? It's very important to know your folder knife. Why this kind of folder knife? Because in many countries, for example, in Austria where I live, these kind of folders are permitted to carry on you because they are manually. It's not something that you push and immediately it's exiting the blade and it's considered can be very dangerous weapon. This also, it's a dangerous weapon. Basically, between putting a button and exit the blade and this, it's not much difference, but it's only the training that is required so you can open it. The way in which I carry my folder, when I'm carrying it, basically every day, when I don't wear this, and also carrying the boat in some days. This is the position, is in the pocket. In this kind of folder, I have the clip in the normal position, because there are some knives, I will show you immediately, just a second, that they have it reverse, yeah? So, like this. Sorry, like this. So it's more difficult when I'm taking in this position up to open it, then already to take it up and open it. I am already in the position and it's helping me very fast to open the knife. So what exercises can I do? I can combine the same exercise like I was doing earlier. Yeah, it's the same thing, only that this hand now make other kinds of movements. So don't complicate yourself to have 10 kinds of knives and every day to change between them, because it's enough to have one or two and your muscle memory will learn to deploy one and another, yeah? So don't complicate yourself, remain simple, yeah? If you are having only a folder and you in the daily carry you have a folder, don't train at home with a machete, yeah? If you want to train because you like, you know, I don't know, the concept of like an art or something, is good. But if you don't carry a machete, don't train with a machete. Train with your weapon that you carry every day. So the same exercise that I was making before, I can apply also here. Entering in guard, striking one, two, then one is going on the knife. I'm taking the knife, open it, stabbing or being prepared to use it. Normally when I enter in guard, I will not come one, two. I was showing earlier, it's not a mistake, but I need time, so I have one strike, and in this time already the other hand is going on the knife. When I deploy the knife, I will not never deploy it in front. Because if my target is closing the distance to me, and I'm making this movement, when I'm making this movement, it can hit his body, and my knife will remain not opened. Yeah, so all the time is the same like when I have a handgun and I'm deploying it in close combat distance. I will not put it in front of me, because if I need to shoot, the slide will hit my body and it's very, very for sure to have a malfunction. So in the same situation, if I'm making this and open it in front and I hit the body of the opponent, it's a malfunction, yeah? You didn't open your knife. It's not ready to use. So I'm using the hand to cover. I'm using the hand to hit. The other is on the knife, and I'm opening the knife laterally. Yeah, I'm opening here. Pop. Taking out, ready to strike. Strike. Yeah. Of course, this is not so easy like this to deploy. If I have the hands from hands up, bam, bam, I'm fighting, and then suddenly I must take it. The time in which I take it is not so fast, like I say to you, like I take this. Yeah. The same I can do, I have the target, I have one strike, one is going on the knife, yeah? One is going on the knife. But I want to say to you that already you are in the position when you have the target here, you already know that you are in the dangerous situation. So when I know this kind of thing, I already prepare. This is the point that I already all the time say to you, the awareness, to see what is happening around you, and you to identify the target before the situation to escalate. So if I know that this guy was a potential threat, already one of my hand is going on the pocket and I am catching the knife and I'm standing with the hand there. One can be up, please. I don't want to fight, doesn't matter. This is going, if in case of he's taking his knife out or something like that, this is going the same. He's going on the face, this is opening, stabbing. So I'm in the position, stab. Stab. In reality, when you have this first strike, your target will not remain there. Yeah, it will not remain fixed. I take a strike in my face and I'm remaining there. The physics will make him move his body. So if I am hitting him, he will not be anymore there. So if I want to strike him, when I take the knife, I must also advance with one step. Because by hitting by here, this target I catch it. But in reality, he will move. It will not be there anymore. So I must move after to hit. If I want only to hit, take the knife out and remain in the guard, this is another thing. This means that I can only change my position, the position of the body, hit, deploy, change and remain with the knife in front. So then I can operate the knife. I come fast back to the discussion that I always remind you every time that knife fighting is not this. Dancing with a partner, moving, in reality is not existing such a thing. So why to train this kind of concept, to learn to my body, to my muscle, to my muscle memory, to learn something that is not efficient and it will not help in that situation, then to train exactly what I need. And in this situation, the most important thing is deploying of the weapon. Of course, the most important thing is awareness, like I say, identifying the targets, the potential threats before the situation to escalate. Because until to use my tools, I can escape this kind of situation without entering in that situation. Yeah. If I'm seeing a group of people that they are drunk and I'm going on their road, in their direction, I'm also with a child or maybe I'm alone, doesn't matter. Identifying that like a potential threat before being there near them, it's making me take other kind of choices, pass the street, take another route and so on. So training things that you don't need, it will not help you. So master the first thing, that it's awareness, and the second thing, that is deploying of the weapon. Yeah, so like I say every time, doesn't help me if I know 1000 techniques and I'm so good with a knife when I have it already in my hand. If before to deploy it, I'm already dead. Yeah. So work on deployment, hours and hours. Stay on deployment and learn to deploy your weapon. Doesn't matter what kind of weapon you have. Learn to deploy your weapons. Tactical pen, the same. Fire weapon, the same. What is the idea if I go to the shooting range, shoot only in 10? If I am not working on how fast I can deploy that weapon. Before, the idea of using the knife to hit is the idea of to deploy it, yeah? Because like I said, a weapon that you are not able to deploy it in time, it's a deadly weapon. It's like, it's dead. It's not alive. You cannot use it. It's not helping you with nothing. When you are not carrying neither fixed blade, neither folder, because you are a law-abiding citizen, because the laws in your country doesn't permit you to wear neither a folder knife, or because you are against this kind of weapons, I don't know, or you don't like it, or I don't know, doesn't matter why, you can come with another variant that is the tactical pen. This is a very efficient tool that can be used and can equilibrate or give you an advantage in a fight, because it's non-lethal. Nobody can this kind of thing you can pass. I am passing all the time, also in airport, in the baggage that I take with me in the airplane. So the idea of striking with this metal pen somebody in soft tissue of the body, neck, eye, even to strike bones, muscles, it's very, very brutal and it's painful. So you can train the same concept with the tactical pen. In my situation, I all the time have the tactical pen in the left, in the weak part, and the folder on the strong side. Why? Because if, for example, I am not, I'm doing something else with this hand, I don't have the time and space to deploy this weapon more fast than the tactical pen, or maybe I'm already with my hand in the pocket, I was in the situation in which something is happening and it's attacking me, I was already there, I will use the tactical pen, so after I can deploy my knife, yeah? If it's a situation in which is required to deploy a deadly weapon like the knife, yeah? If not, I will also only strike with the tactical pen. Exercises, you have a ball, put it on the wall, you want precision every time. Pop. Strike, strike, strike. Then strike, go back. Strike, go back. These are simple exercises that you can use and make it everywhere. I am in my apartment, I am in my room. You don't need gyms, you don't need special places to make your training and to become better in your skills. If you want to wear all the three weapons at you, it's your choice. Many times I'm wearing it. So in my training, I combine all of them. So for example, I'm in the position in which I use the tactical pen hit. I'm creating distance and deploying my knife, prepared to operate with the knife. So it's the same situation when I was with the empty hands, hitting far, taking the knife out and be prepared to stab, only that in this moment, in my hand, I have also the tactical pen that is more useful when I am hitting already the target. If I hit the face, the eye, the neck, it's already incapacitating for few fraction of second, or maybe for a long period of time. Bam, I'm taking out and I prepare. The same stuff with the folder. I am one hitting, going on the folder, taking it out and be ready to use it. When you begin to master a little bit this kind of techniques, there are few techniques that I was showing you, but you can start with them. I will come with other videos, more and more advanced. After you manage a little bit this kind of techniques, you can implement it in your training, also something that is requiring you physical force. So, if I am seeing that I'm in a normal condition, without making a lot of effort before, and I can deploy my knife or my things very fast, and also I'm precise, doesn't mean that in reality is the same. In reality are many, many factors that will influence this deployment and your strike and your reaction to the action. The meteorological factors, the idea that your heart rate beats will increase, your breathing, everything, the suddenly sweating, maybe it's cold outside, and maybe you have blood on your hands. Many, many things that will influence this. So to start to increase a little bit the level, put between them, I repeat, when you are doing this at the beginning, don't make it with real knives. Don't make it with real tools, like real knives, because you will cut yourself. So use trainers and rubber knives. So after I'm managing a little bit, for example, I have here a resistant band, a rubber band. This is something like, I don't remember, but between 30 and 50 kilos. 13 and 50 kilos, yeah. It's not so powerful, it's not so resistant, but by making different exercises, for example, what I recommend if you have this kind of exercise, what I'm doing also, I have also kettlebells of 10, of 20 kilos that I'm using. And I'm starting making 30 repetition, for example, for the all the time when I'm making, combine it with the training for the knife and training for the fire weapons. I am training the upper body, especially the arms. It's not about training. I am forcing the upper body. So after the arms, after I'm finishing, I am making my movements. Yeah, 1, 3, 4, 5. Doesn't matter. I am repeating continuously the movement until I feel that my hands are tired, that my hands are shaking. Yeah, I'm continuing, I'm making it, and when I'm feeling that my hands are shaking, then I let the band and I'm deploying and making my techniques. Why? Because in that moment my hands are tired. That is a little bit of stress for the situation, and it's simulating a little bit the concept of that how it will be in reality. Yeah, you will be very tired immediately. So after I'm making this, then I will make the techniques. You don't have a rubber resistant band, you can take two kettlebells, two weights, doesn't matter, yeah, and make the same thing with it. Yeah, I'm working, making the exercises, pumping the muscle until my muscles are feeling tired. Then I'm finishing. My body is shaking when I finish my 20 repetition, 30 repetition. Then I'm coming to the target and making the techniques. Yeah, doesn't matter. 1, 2, 3, 5. Now I will show you also with the fire weapon, combining the exercise that we make until now also with the fire weapon. I repeat, in this case, it's a airsoft replica. Doesn't matter, we all the time treat it like a real weapon, check inside. Tomorrow maybe you'll have the real weapon, and if you are not making an automatism muscle memory, you will skip this phase. So I was checking the inside the chamber room because I don't have magazine. Yeah, the magazine, it's not inside. Yeah, if it was magazine, take it out, check it, and then use the weapon. So it's an airsoft replica. You can use it the same, buy one. It's very real, it's very good for this kind of training, especially when you are in an environment that is not permitting you here. Yeah, if my children or my family is in other room, I cannot train with the fire weapon, even if I take the measures of the security measures. So this is an airsoft replica. I have it in a lateral holster, in the normal holster. Many times I'm training from the appendix position with the appendix holster. So what I'm doing now, like I said earlier, you don't need special conditions. Yeah, Okay, real shooting fire with fire weapon at the shooting range. It's what we want and what we aim for to make it most how much we can about this kind of training. But a large amount of time that is very important to invest in is the dry fire. Dry fire means, like in this situation, I am using a replica gun and I'm not shooting with the bullets. Yeah, I'm only trained to learn the movements of deploying the weapon, of aligning my sights, and this kind of things. Yeah, so I don't say now to you, it's normal you have a gun. Maybe many of you that you already have a handgun, you know this kind of exercise. May there are so many videos about dry firing. If you want, you can comment, let a comment in my in the comment section to my video, and I will do it in the future also regarding the fire weapon, what kind of drills I do, especially only for the fire weapon. For the idea in this situation, I am using the lateral holster. I want to say that when you are in the real situation, and I mean close distance, yeah, if you are a police officer, if you are, I don't know, a civilian that have the weapon, if you are a civilian, you will not have it that people will see it. Yeah, you will have a jacket, it will be concealed. I will show also with the jacket after. Let's say that you are an operator to, I don't know, what kind of police or unit or other stuff like this. If I'm in a close range distance, I see so many videos about attack with a knife or aggression, and the guy is taking the gun, it's running around, rolling. Even me in the past, I was doing and experimented this stuff. To be more concise. If you for this thing to be good and to be able to react very fast in this situation, you must be very, very good. You must train hours and hours, and even in that situation, it's nothing fixed. Yeah. So what I am doing, my concept in tactical combat system, I am using blades, other kind of tools. So helping me with this kind of tools, like I am striking with a tactical pen, I am creating the distance. I am striking, I am creating the distance. Strike, create the distance that is permitting me to deploy the weapon for shooting. I don't have so much space here, so this is the reason why I'm not going more in the back, and I will exit from the camera, so you catch the idea. When I'm making this and I say I create the distance, it's not that I'm remaining here. Yeah, this is not distance. Distance means that I'm going out 1 meter, 2 meters, 2 meters, 3 meters out, and I can operate my weapon with one hand normally in this condition. So all this stuff normally, when you are deploying the weapon, my hand is going on the holster, one is on the chest level. I'm deploying the weapon, they are meeting together. I must be careful here, not fishing with the gun and not making this kind of movement. It's how I must reduce the movements how much I can. It's coming the weapon in front of the thoracic box. It's meeting with the other hand that it's covering. It's coming on it. It's covering all the space that is remaining between. And I am going on the target. My elbows are contracted. Not too far, not here. I try to make it as much as I can in the exterior, so I have a good equilibrated position. I take the aim, I align the sights. When I am aligning the sights, of course, if I have already a secure and I am identifying already the target, the finger, it's already, if I am on the target, already in the line, even if I don't have the alignment of the sights, it's going on the trigger, be prepared, and when I meet the sights, I'm pushing it and it's going to shoot, yeah? After I'm shooting, I'm coming back all the time in this position. let's say I'm shooting all the time, I repeat moving, yeah, laterally, not staying in the same position and shooting, fixed target, it's dead target. After I'm shooting all the time, I'm bringing the gun here, checking with my sight if I have a malfunction, because if I have a malfunction and it's a second malfunction, second time malfunction with the bullet with the stuck with the tube stuck on the chamber, then if I'm not checking this and suddenly I have another threat and I turn back to shoot, I was not ready and it will take me by surprise and I must operate the malfunction. If I am shooting, I am seeing already, I can find cover position or other or making the malfunction in such a way that can I can operate fast again the weapon. So now I am near the target, I am having already on the tactical pen prepared, I am close to the target, I am starting the action, hitting with the tactical pen, the soft body, going back, moving as much as I can, I repeat, I will remain in this position, so you see, I am deploying the weapon, shooting, checking other threats and finish this kind of drill. So I'm here. One. If you are a civilian, like I say to you, you cannot carry the weapon, even if you are allowed it and you have this possibility in your country to carry the weapon with you, you cannot have it many times in many countries at the side, people to see it, yeah? So you will have probably a jacket that is concealing your gun, yeah? One thing, when you have a jacket and you're shooting from this concealed position, be careful because this movement will require this kind of thing, yeah? I must take my jacket out in such a way that I will free the holster and I'm coming, I can come with the out with the gun. And for these things, I have some tips. It's not mine, they are not my tips. I also learned it from others. Put inside the pocket, if you have your keys, put your keys, or put something that is heavy in such a way that this jacket will fly faster than if you don't have nothing. So the situation is the same. If I am in the in this kind of position, I am hitting with a tactical pen, making space and deploying my weapon. In the same time, when I am hitting, I am hitting and my hand is taking the jacket, give it out, take the gun, shoot. If it's too close, the target to me, after I'm hitting with my tactical pen, I'm taking the jacket, I'm not coming with the gun straight in front, because the target is very close of me, so he can catch the gun. Many things can happen, yeah? So, all the time, it's a kind of shooting that is in close quarter distance, in which the aggressor is very close. Maybe I miss with the tactical pen, or I catch him only a little bit, a fraction of a second, but he's continuing his movement. So after I'm doing this, the gun is taking out, and I am rotating it in diagonal a little bit, like I said to you at the beginning. Don't shoot from here, when it will shoot, this light will hit your body and you will have a malfunction. So I am hitting, taking the gun out, rotate it because the target is very close of me, and I'm shooting one, two bullets, it's instinctive fire, until, and I continue my movement back until I create the space so I can align my sights very good and my hand in a better shooting position. Okay guys, I will show you now how I another kind of techniques that I am doing when I have the gun in the appendix position. For this time I will use a holster for the trigger guard. Basically you put it on the belt, it's having a paracord, you put it on the belt, catch by the belt, go on the belt, then I put on the trigger And this thing is not permitting anymore to push the trigger, yeah? Like you see. After this, you put it inside your appendix position. After you have it in the appendix position, basically it's the same mechanism when I was doing with the knife, bam, bam, yeah, taking the clothes up, taking the knife and stab. The same is here, I'm taking up, I'm taking the gun out, shoot. So again, I'm I have the gun carried in an appendix position in this kind of holster. I'm taking up the shirt, I'm catching the gun, I'm taking it out. When I'm taking out, I take care the barrel to not be positioned through my body. So I'm taking out the gun, trying as much as I can already the hand to have this kind of movement. I'm here shooting if it's needed. A very good minimalist holster. So what is the idea? Because I cannot access, if I have a very close target near me, I cannot access in this moment the gun, because he can strike me, he can have the knife and strike me and all these kind of things. I will use to access the knife or the tactical pen. In this situation, the tactical pen is much easier because I am using this weak hand. Yeah, so basically I am hitting with a tactical pen. Then I create the distance, I make distance, I go back. I am catching with the hand the t-shirt, having also the tactical pen, it's not so hard. Getting out the clothes, taking out the gun and be prepared to shoot. So faster, I repeat all the time with the idea that I exit from the camera now and you don't see me good how I deploy, and this is more important with the idea of creating space and going back when I deploy the weapon, because this tactical pen, this strike, it's only for this to create the space and the distance so I can deploy the handgun. The tactical pen and combine with the handgun. The same thing now but with the knife. I have this hand that is striking the target. This is deploying the knife because I was already with the hand on the knife, yeah, and I use this strike to create the time. I'm deploying the weapon, stabbing, changing the hand, stabbing, creating the distance, taking the gun out. Of course that this kind of techniques I show to you, and this kind of exercises again to make you aware of the possibility to change hand-to-hand combat to blade fighting and to fire weapons. So it's all together mixed, so you will not have this space and this blockage in the situation in which you are fighting with empty hands and suddenly the other one is taking a knife and you must deploy fast your knife. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget, if you like the content, give a like to the video, subscribe to my channel, and also comment in the section below what other topics you want that I create videos about.